All right, so the Raspberries go all the way. This is Eric Carmen wrote this song and sings it. And the guitar player is a guy called Wally Bryson out of Cleveland. And he's a really good guitar player. And that's him doing, you know, doing all that stuff. And as you go through the song, you'll see he has a really good knowledge of the fretboard and all the voicings and whatnot. Really good guitar player. And the song came out in 1972. And it's one of those songs that just has, I know it's got like a personality disorder. it's about six songs in one, right? And I think for most guys that have my kind of taste, we love the beginning, you know? That. Is so good. You know, it's so like a. You know, it's so such a great intro, and that actually, Brown Sugar came out in 71, and this came out in 72. So I'm pretty sure that he was, you know, thinking about that intro when he came up with that, right? So there's that part which comes back later on the song, and there's the. You know, that great ending, just so Beatle-ish, bad finger type. So all those parts, you know, I just love those parts. And I actually read a thing that Eddie Trunk, if anybody knows who Eddie Trunk is, guy from that metal show, like a radio guy, he's really kind of into metal and rock and stuff. But he said that hearing that, you know, he's in the back of his dad's car and he heard that, and that's what kind of turned him on to rock music, right? Because that part is so good. Anyways, then it kind of gets into this Beach Boys, Don't Worry Baby kind of thing. It's almost like bubblegum, that part, right? And then it gets into that, which is like Hold Me Tight by the Beatles. And then the vocals in that part, he's kind of lifting the come-ons from Please Please Me, right? So it's just all these things in the song that influences that make it just it's a bit too much, really, I think, you know. But regardless, a lot of people just love this song. Excuse me. And it got a kind of a rebirth with the Guardians of the Galaxy, which was featured on the soundtrack. But anyways, like most people, it's that intro and that ending that really stick with me. But we're going to go over the whole song regardless, okay? So we're in the key of A here at standard tuning. And a lot of guys think it's like this. Okay, because that's super easy to do. But problem is that Wally Bryson is playing it down here. Okay, and that's like a D-shaped A chord. Right? But he's adding in that A note on D7 as well as the open, right? So before you even get to that third up there, you've got this, right? Which normally most of us would play like that. It's really super powerful power chord, right? No thirds. So you've got that underneath that. And that's, in my opinion, what gives it that unique sound. But problem is, that's really tough to do for most guys. And I had to work on this quite a bit, actually. Because I never, ever play that chord. Right? I had to kind of get my fingers used to doing it that way. So we're going to go there. And then the next chord is, we're going to bend our little finger over here to catch E10. To make for that A sus 4. And then we're back to that. So it's. Okay, and then we're. And that's from there to here. That's like a D chord. But we're just playing the G and the B and the high E string. And we're not even really sounding that high E. It's mostly like there. And we're going to play open A and open D. Okay, and like I say, that's tricky. You know, there's a bunch of ways you can cheat that. Like, you could go like this. And just do that regular D shape on that last note. Right? I'm just getting there. Like that, right? I mean, you could just go. If you want it. But you're missing that note, which kind of adds. You wouldn't think it would add much, but it does. It adds a lot of depth. But if you did it this way, you're only going to miss that note on that last chord. And the first chord, you don't even hear that third. You're mostly hearing that. Okay, so that's a way to cheat around it, but ideally, you want to get it like that. Okay, now we're going to get into this. Okay, and that is like that from the third fret of the A. And then here. Okay, second time. We do that slide up on the A, right? Okay, and the last time we're gonna go right. Sliding in from the 4th to the 5th on the D, and that's like a G power chord, right? No thirds, just root, root, 5th, root. And that's the intro. And the lower guitar, you know, you watch Eric Carmen play his part, he's kind of here. Right, but I did mine down here. Right, just really basic. And the guitar's double that. But instead of being there, you'd go. Right? Okay, and that's both guitar parts of the intro. Now, we get into the verses and the chorus. The verse is like, I think it's only 4 bars long. So, by going to that G, now we've modulated into the key of C, okay? And so, the verse goes like this. Okay, so all that is C, A minor, and then D minor, and I like to use my little finger there, because the next chord is this. It's B minor 7 flat 5. Okay, and if you watch Eric Carmen play this on those old videos, you'll see him fingering it more like that. Just more like a straight B minor 7, A2, G2, B3. And I think that's just because it's easier to do that. But if you want to get that flat 5 in there, it'll make a difference, right? Because the higher part, which I'll go over in a minute, is definitely getting that flat 5 in there. And then it's to E7, okay? So we've got A minor, B minor, B minor 7, flat 5, E7. And there again, now we've changed key. We're back into A now. Okay, the way he's doing that is, you know, way to change key in pop music, and you see it all the time, is you just precede whatever key you want to go into by the fifth, by its fifth, right? The fifth of A is E, E7. Okay, so verse. I can't sing. So now we're into the chorus, and it's going to be A, F sharp minor, and then D, and I do the D like that because I want to be able to go, right? Real, real easy change. If you do it that way, you get into this kind of awkward little finger thing, right? So there, you do the B minor 7. Okay, so chorus. B minor 7 to E7, and then C sharp minor 7 to F sharp 7, and then B minor, D minor, and then to get back into the next verse, G. Okay, G will get you back into C. G is the fifth of C, right? Okay, so the verse goes again, or the sorry, the chorus, the verse goes again, then another chorus, and then eventually we get it. We get back into that. So coming out of that last chorus, we're like, D minor, E7, and then we're, or okay, and this will head into the kind of the bridge where we just keep playing that. It's too lonely, I gotta. We go to an F, G, and an A. And then there's a little lick there, okay? And then it's this again. F, G, A, B. And that will lead us into the next section, which is that hold me tight, Beatles, please, please me sort of thing, right? And by going up to that B, you know, B is the fifth of E. It leads us into another key change, right? I don't know how many key changes that is so far, but there's a lot. So, F, G, A, and then we've got, which is right? That's the lick. One more time. Okay, and then we, now F, G, A, B, and now we're to this, which is just that whole, it's hold me tight, right? And then we go to A, instead of going, we go, right, little hammer on there, so it's back to E, we do that hammer again, A, now we go to D, and do the exact same lick, now we're going to go to G, we're just going to go G, B, D, B. Now we're going to go to C, and we're going to go, right? C, E, G, A. And then we've got E sus4, E. Okay, so go over that whole bit real slow. And then we're into the chorus. Okay? And then that chorus goes on, and we finally kind of come out of that chorus, and we wind up into this part. Okay, so what we've got there is just an F sharp minor. Right? Just barring here the G, B, and E. And it's D4, right? And we've got a little finger here on E4. So, ding, 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 ding. Right? So it's the same lick, just descending bass, right? So, and right, just forward, backward and forward, right? And then we've got this D with your little middle finger off, so you got that open E. And then we've got this rhythmic lick, which is just that G4 B3 down to this A, right? So the G and the B strings. So da, da, da. Then we've got F, right? Bum, 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 bum. So we've got from here. And then B minor 7, E7, and then we're back into that. Okay, so that whole section real slow. Okay, and that's pretty well it, except for in the verses and the chorus, there's that slashing guitar, right? Okay, so in that verse, we're in C. So he's just slashing on these higher voiced chords, right? That's like C, A minor, D minor, like that, but only this part. And then we've got this, where you're going to bar on the 10th fret G, B, and E, and add D9. That's your B minor 7 flat 5. And then to E7, right? All right, so. Now, that's taken us into the key of A, and we're going to slash here on this D-shaped A chord. And we just stay there, right? Till we get to the D. That's D, C-sharp minor, B minor. Slash, backslash on E7. C sharp minor 7, and then we're going to go E to F sharp, right? Because the lower guitar is just going, but the upper guitar is going to go, going to throw in that extra E chord there. And then B minor, and then D minor, G, because we're heading back into a verse in the key of C, right? Okay. But the second time through, we're going to go from B minor, E. And that takes us back into that, right? Okay, so there's a lot of stuff going on in these guitar parts, right? And if you're playing this live, obviously you're going to have two-channel amp, because that clean sound is super clean with lots of delay and reverb. You know, that slashing part. And of course, if you watch that old video of him, he's got the double neck guitar, right? You know, the top part is really clean and the lower part is his distorted sound. Okay, so that's pretty well all the parts there. And of course, it just goes back into the ending, right? I didn't do that on my demo, but he does that little neck push, you know, where you push, kind of hold your guitar and push the neck to get that little modulation there. Okay, so that's it for this one. I hope I got all those parts in there, a lot of parts. But the key, really, the takeaway is learn how to do that. If you want to sound authentic, you know, you got to get that chord shape, right? Okay. That's it. I hope you get something out of this one. Hope you enjoy playing it. And we'll talk to you next time.